To the graduating seniors of the class of 2018, this is Coach Cook, and since I was not able to address you at graduation, I wanted to send you this final farewell and consider it my last lesson to you. You know, much has been said about your generation. Most of it is negative. People chastise you. They're very open about it on social media, saying things like that you're lazy, or that you have no discernible skills, that this generation spends too much time on their phones, that they eat Tide Pods. And I want you to get used to that. I want you to get used to hearing negativity, because what you'll find when you go out into the world are a lot of people who are great at identifying problems. And what you're not going to find are people who are offering legitimate solutions to problems. Don't let other people's negativity determine the course of your life. Be prepared for people to tell you that you can't. And let me offer you some advice, because those of you that know me know that I tend to like to give advice. Oftentimes, people in your generation say things like, when you look back on your life, you'll only regret the things that you didn't do. And people, that's just stupid. There are plenty of people in prison that would completely disagree with that philosophy of life. Every dangerous path begins with a single choice, a single decision, just like every life plan begins with a single choice, a single decision. You see, we want to be judged by our intentions and not be judged by our actions. But in reality, we judge other people by their actions and don't even consider what their intentions were. Actions matter. Every day you make choices. Choices have consequences, both good and bad. I believe that people should live intentionally. People should live their life with a purpose. There's more to life than Instagram followers, Snapchat streaks, and Fortnite. In fact, I've often considered, if I were to die today, what would the legacy of my life be? And I challenge you to consider the exact same question. If you left the earth today, what would the legacy of your life be? How would you be remembered? What would you have contributed to the world? Discover your talents, your hopes, your dreams. Find what you are passionate about. Spend your time developing your talents. Read. Better yourself. Create something. Add something of value to the world. Immerse yourself in new culture, in new ideas, embrace new philosophies, contemplate meaning, pursue a career that fulfills you. I cannot state that enough. There is a difference between fulfillment and happiness. Happiness is an emotion, it is not a pursuit. Find what fulfills you and pursue it. Have a positive impact on people. Do not spend your time as if you have an unlimited amount of it. Put yourself out there. Take risks. Don't spend life on the sidelines hoping and wishing that something good happens to you. Pursue your passion. Have a plan and do not shy away from challenge. Do not be afraid to do the work. Do the work. Do not be afraid of failure. Do not let your fear of failure prevent you from putting yourself out there. See, in my life, I've learned a lot more from failure than I have from my success. See, we don't tend to evaluate the things that we did well. We only tend to evaluate the things that went poorly. And therein lies the growth. Do not fear failure. The only difference between successful people and unsuccessful people is determination. The perseverance to continue to pursue something, even when it hasn't turned out the way that we hoped it did. If they tell you that you cannot do something, I want you to fight harder. If they tell you that you will not do something, I want you to fight even harder. When the chances of success are bleak and minuscule, then I want you to dig deep and I want you to fight the hardest. And finally, when it is obvious that you have run out of options and that there is no hope, I want you to fight with everything that you have left in you. Pursue what you are passionate about. Because someday, someone will be standing in front of a room reading your eulogy to family. So I ask you the question again, what will the legacy of your life be? As of today, you still can be whatever you want to be. It has not yet been decided for you. When you sat in that arena at graduation today, as the class of 2018, that was the last time that you would be in the same place at the same time as an entire group. I know many of you have considered that, and some of you may not. But at this moment, you can still be whatever you want to be. you have yet to make the decisions that will shape the course of your future. You'll leave this place, you'll go on to bigger and better things, you'll go your separate ways, and you'll begin to create individual journeys and lives for yourselves. Live your life intentionally. Live with a purpose. Someday, before you even realize it, this will all just be a distant memory. This day, this senior year, you have grown up, you have moved on, and built for yourself a life. And my desire for you is that that life will be fulfilled, that it will be meaningful, that it will be full of joy, and that you will have made our society a better place than you found it. Live intentionally. Finally, I leave you with this. Years ago, my wife and I decided to forego lucrative careers to become educators. A career that would be spent mentoring and shaping the minds and futures of young students. And coming back to the community that I grew up in, the school system that educated me, the community that raised me, I've learned a few things. And as you leave this place and go to your various locations, whatever's next for you, I want you to remember this. You're gonna build the process of a new life and a better future, but I want you to save a space in your heart and in your mind for this place. Because this place is different, and this place is special. And even though you're excited about the future, don't forget where you came from and what this place has done for you. You've left your legacy on this place. You've done lots of good things for this school and for this community. And I want you to remember this, seniors. I've learned this in my own life, and I want you to go with this final message. That once you become a Gulf Breeze Dolphin, you will always be a Gulf Breeze Dolphin. I love you. I wish the best for you. I hope the world has everything that you could ever want. Congratulations, class of 2018.